brought to you by 1AAuto.com, your source for quality parts and the best service on the internet.
Hi, I'm Mike from 1AAuto. I hope this how-to video helps you out. And next time you need parts for your vehicle, think of 1AAuto.com. Thanks.
In this video, we're going to be showing you how to change out the driver's side CV axle in this 1998 Toyota Camry 2.2 liter inline four. This information is the same from 1992 to 2001. Some symptoms of your CV axle going bad is a clicking sound when turning, especially at full lock. You'll really hear these start to make a clicking sound, and you might even get a little bit of kind of a clunk feeling in the floor pan. You may also notice that the boots have ripped and that they're spraying grease on the underside of the car, which can contaminate your brakes and cause braking issues, as well as making a mess under there and eventually drying out the joint and creating that clicking sound anyway. If you like this video, please click subscribe. We have a ton more information on this vehicle and many other makes and models. And if you want this part for your car, you can follow the link in the description. It's available from 1AAuto.com. Here are the items you'll need for this repair. Break all your lug nuts loose while the vehicle's still on the ground. Gonna need a 21 millimeter socket and a breaker bar. Install your jack under the vehicle. Line it up with the pinch weld. Jack the vehicle up high enough that you can get a stand underneath. Making sure you have enough clearance to remove your tire or do whatever you have to do under the vehicle. Install your jack stand onto this unibody frame rail under the vehicle. With the vehicle raised and supported, remove your lug nuts the rest of the way. You need a little more room to work, you can pull the hubcap off. Remove your wheel from the hub. We've put our vehicle on a lift to make it easier to film for you, but this job can be easily done with a jack and jack stands. Bend down the cotter pin. Use a pair of needle nose pliers, or if you're having a hard time straightening it out, you can also cut it at the straightest point with a pair of side cutters. Top of our cotter pin broke in half, so now we'll grab it with a pair of needle nose locking pliers and work it out one side at a time. Remove the lock cover on the nut using a 32 millimeter breaker bar and a pry bar braced against the lug nuts. We'll break our axle nut socket loose and remove it. Leave the nut flush with the end of the axle. This will allow us to tap the splines free from the hub without risking damaging the axle or the threads. Now remove the axle nut the rest of the way. We'll remove this 12 millimeter bolt retaining the ABS wire and the flexible brake line with a socket, ratchet, and extension. Remove the line and the ABS harness, as well as this plastic clip, and allow them to hang freely. Using a 22 millimeter socket and a breaker bar, break the nuts loose for the strut and remove them the rest of the way with a ratchet. Remove the nuts, and these bolts are splines, so we'll have to carefully tap them out of the spindle. We're going to use a flat punch and a hammer to tap the bolts out of the spindle. Now you could tap the ends of the bolt very carefully, but there's a lot of risk of damaging threads there. So we'll set the punch up in the center of the bolt. Once they're most of the way through, we should be able to rock the spindle. And finish removing them. Pull the spindle down and out of the strut. Be careful of this flex line to make sure that you don't put too much tension and tear it. Now we can remove the CV axle from the spindle. And allow it to hang down. Follow the CV axle back to the transmission. And here, we're going to set two pry bars as close to 3 and 9 as we can, because prying out evenly is the key to removing these axles smoothly. We're going to carefully work the snap ring out of its holder inside of the differential. Another method you can try is using a large punch on the back of the CV axle. Be sure to have a drain bucket placed underneath the CV axle before popping it out with your pry bars. Once you've dislodged the CV axle snap ring from the differential, you can fully remove the axle. Make sure that that snap ring is still on the end of the shaft, as the new axle won't go in if that's lodged inside the transmission. Here we have our old part that we removed from our vehicle and our new part from 1AAuto.com. As you can see, there are some minor aesthetic differences here. However, this is a direct fit part. See, we have the same splines, threads, even comes with a new axle nut and a new cap for it. We'll have to put a new cotter pin in there as well. Has the ABS sensor ring here. The actual shaft diameter is a little bit thicker on our new part. That makes it a little stronger. And the difference on the inboard joint here is that this channel goes all the way around, making it easier to hook on at that 9 3/4 points to pop it out of the transmission, should you ever have to do that again. Whereas these, it's kind of hard to line up and get on both sides evenly to pop it out. Has a new dust boot on the end to keep stuff from getting into the transmission, like road grime and debris. We even have a new snap ring that's going to lock into the differential and keep this inboard joint in place. So if your CV axles are clicking or have torn boots and are throwing grease, this new part from 1A Auto is going to go in direct fit, just like your original equipment, and fix you up right. Get some transmission fluid onto your finger and lubricate the splines on the inboard joint that are going to be going into the differential, just to make sure they go in a little bit smoother and that they don't damage the seal on the way in. Send the axle back into position. You may have to wiggle it a little to get the splines to line up, and work the joint back into the transmission. Line up the splines back into the hub. Once they're in place, we'll start the axle nut on a few threads by hand to make sure that it doesn't fall out of the hub while we line up the bottom of the strut. Lift up and line up the bolt holes in the spindle. Once it's lined up, reinstall your strut bolts. These go in from the front. Simply push in from the top. Line up the top hole and tap the bolt shoulders back into place. start your 22 millimeter nuts. Torque the two nuts to 156 foot-pounds. Snap the ABS retainer back into place. Lock it over the slot here in the bracket. Hook the ABS sensor back into the bracket, as well as the flexible brake line. Reinstall your 12 millimeter bolt. And we'll tighten that down with a socket, ratchet, and extension. Use your 30 millimeter socket and a ratchet to tighten down the axle nut. Reinstall the wheel and tire. Tighten down the nuts. Put the vehicle onto the ground so you can then torque the axle nut. Check that they're all seated. If you've removed the tire, only lower the vehicle until the wheel touches the ground. With partial weight of the vehicle on the ground, torque your lug nuts to 76 foot-pounds in a cross pattern. Then you can remove your jack the rest of the way. Torque the axle nut to 217 foot-pounds. Install the lock cap over the axle nut and a new cotter pin. Bend the cotter pin around the end of the axle. Reinstall your hub cap and you're good to go.
Thanks for tuning in. We hope this video helped you out. Next time you need parts for your car, please visit 1AAuto.com. Also check out our other helpful how-to as well as diagnosis videos.